Don't forget the word A. Artificial. It isn't intelligent. It's pattern matching and it's doing things, but it has actually no deep understanding at all. None at all. But it could do wonderful things. So I've tried using it. Well, you know, I'm not so good at sketching. Maybe I can ask it to draw the pictures that illustrate my concepts. And it works reasonably well, except I can't just say, oh, here's a picture I want and get a nice, wonderful result. I have to say, here's a picture I want, and then look at it and say, that's not what I want. And then I have to figure out a way of describing what I want and then go back and forth. And so it's much more a collaboration. We don't do the technical drawings anymore, but rather we do it with the aid of a computer program. It can do the stress analysis and tell us whether it's strong enough, whether it's going to work. That simply makes your work more powerful. Let it do that stuff. So it's a collaboration because we think of the idea and then we have to judge what it produces to say whether that's at all what we thought of. And sometimes, and this is a great thing about collaboration, sometimes it will produce something that's so weird and strange and we sit and look at it and say, oh, wow, I would never have thought of that. Maybe that's a really important direction to go. And then you can spend a few more days shaping it with it. So we're going to have to learn to think and design in a very different way. But that's been true of every advance in technology over the ages. Every time a new technology comes in, it changes the way we behave. And most of the time, in positive ways. But it takes a while for us to get used to it. And that's what I think will happen with AI.